Hey everybody, Rob from Karma Comet Chameleon coming at you with another pro-revenge story. This is a home, not a prison. Yet, let's jump right in. Greetings all. Well, Mother's Day has come and gone once again. Children of all types have spent the day annoying their mothers enough that she is pleased to see them either leave or go back to their old routines and just leave her to her peace. Now, I am not a mother myself, but if you have read my first ever post on Reddit, then you all have at least heard of my mother. If not, then let me tell you a tale. One of bratty kids, an overworked mother, and her revenge. Sit back, relax, because my mother can break your back. This is entirely true. She's a chiropractor. She actually learned how to break someone's neck and back to know the signs just in case she ever came close to actually doing it. Which, okay, wow, scary. But she learned it in a university setting on cadavers, so all good? Let's take a look back, way back to the time of the first stirrings of the Y2K bug, where people believed that the world was going to end in a nuclear holocaust because the computers were going to hit 00 when the year 2000 came around. It was almost the summer of 1999. I was just a twig of a child, mostly gangly limbs and big eyes, and all of 11 years old or so. The cast for this tale is A, my eldest step-sibling, N, the catalyst of this tale, M, me, the Bambi-looking gullible mofo who should have known better, Lou, stepbrother, my age, and he should have known better too, K, younger sister by 2 years, and L, youngest, the baby of the family. Now, my mother remarried a man we shall call RG when I was about 8 years old. Due to the whole soap incident, he delegated all forms of discipline to her when it came to punishing us on a whole. So due to her working long 13-hour days to support us all, and the lack of allowance for doing chores because, let's face it, six kids tend to run you dry if you try to keep up with it all, we, the children, started slacking off. This did not sit well with my mother, who used her usual threat of, "I will go into your rooms and whatever is on the floor goes in the garbage." This is something we had heard all our lives, but us younger kids, as in me and all below me, totally believed she would do it. Until this one faithful day. It was gorgeous outside. The sun was shining, spring had brought new leaves to the trees, and all the neighborhood kids could be heard screaming through the streets because the 90s were a time of uncontrolled childhood chaos where parents happily released their spores into the wild and drank wine while they didn't have to think about their hellspawn until the streetlights flicked on. Unfortunately for us, my mother decided that this gorgeous weekend day was best used for picking up the slack that we let get away from us. She demanded we clean our rooms while repeating that well-known phrase we all knew and despised. We groaned, we whined, we relented, and started to comply. But then my sister N, the stone-cold and wisest of the elder sisters, just shrugged and ignored the order. Her and A shared a room, practically having one side of the upper floor, which had a wall knocked down and renovated into almost like a mini apartment sans kitchen, all to themselves. And at the all-knowing age of 13, N and 15, A, they both decided they had better things to do that day than listen to our mom. A left to go on a date with her boyfriend she made the year before, and N sat in her room on her computer, a giant PC of a thing linked into a separate line so the dial-up wouldn't fudge up our phone systems. When we, the younger kids, started bugging her, shocked at her audacity, my sister N said these words, "It's not like she's actually going to throw all our stuff away. She paid for it all. She's not just going to toss it all out because that's a waste of money. This is a home, not a prison. She's not the warden, and we don't have to do what she says." Then she left us standing there with our puny, impressionable minds totally blown. We didn't have to do what mom said? Is that even possible? My younger sister Kay and my brother Lou took this at face value and immediately took off. They were 11, Lou, and 9, Kay, and had friends waiting on them. They didn't have time to waste cleaning their rooms on an empty threat. L, only 7 years old, was more hesitant, but was as easily distracted as I was, and we ended up playing Barbies for the rest of the day, totally forgetting about our worries until dinner time. Silence. Dinner was quiet, awkward. Mom was pissed the house did not get cleaned, and RG was ready to lay his hammer down at my mother's command. The interrogation went as expected, and Kay, our more, expressive sister, who had a bit of Raph from the Ninja Turtles type personality, blew up, figuratively, at my mother. This is a home, Mom, not a prison, and it's my room. With this, dinner was concluded. Kay stormed off, Mom went quiet, and with the most Stepford Wife smile ever, just asked us all if we felt this way. My elder sisters agreed immediately, not really caring because of teenage angst, and we younger kids slowly nodded at their insistent stares. I see. And that was that. No punishments, no scoldings or groundings, and the rest of the weekend went off without a hiccup. We should have known something was up. Mom sent us all off to school Monday herself, which was unusual because she usually woke before us and was gone by the time we finished brushing our teeth. We then wouldn't see her until dinner later in the day, but she made us a big breakfast, hinted at a surprise for us when we got home from school, kissed us goodbye, and sent us happily out the door. Now, I'm sure you're all thinking that I should get on with it. What was the revenge, and how does it fit into pro-revenge? Well, I'll tell you. Mom's revenge. While we were at school, Mom, RG, and some of his friends came in and got rid of everything that would be enjoyable to a child. The basement was emptied and cleaned. All computers, video games, Game Boys, CD players, radios, and TVs were taken. Dressers and closets were emptied. Toys upon toys were tossed. Colorful blankets and sheets removed from beds. Decorations, pencils and coloring tools, paper and scissors, glue, basically any and all craft supplies, gone. When we returned home, RG was in his military uniform and accosted us as we came in through the door, pinned us to the wall, and frisked each of us. Backpacks, candy, and everything we had on us were taken. My mother then handed us some gray pajamas and ordered us to march into the bathroom to change. Terrified, we complied. The living room seemed so bare. The piano recorder was gone, along with the TV. The puzzles and games usually kept in the room gone from the shelves. The bathroom was no better. Bare, except head and shoulders, and a bar of soap on a string for some reason. It smelled strongly of bleach. We were then sat down on lawn chairs, the couch occupied by my stone-cold mother, as we waited for every child to arrive in silence. Welcome to the month of hell. We watched as my mother tossed all our clothes into a garbage bag, all toys and art supplies from our backpacks followed, and RG was in uniform and with his scariest expression as my mother went through our new itinerary for life from now on. Wake up at dawn, PT in the mornings through the town led by RG, oatmeal, no sugar, for breakfast, then off to school. Drop off made to the classrooms by RG, and pick up the moment the bell goes at the end of the day. Lunch is roast beef sandwiches, barely any mayo, and wilted lettuce. School has been informed to not give us anything else, and to take away anything not given to us by our parents. Once home, we are each assigned a room to clean, our bags taken and checked for contraband. Room clean, PT on the backyard, a deflated soccer ball as a toy, nothing else. Leave the fenced-in area and you get extra punishment. No friends, calls, or escape. Dinner was cold peas, corn, beans, and mystery meat. No butter, salt, or ketchup was allowed. You don't take care of your home, you don't deserve your home. Welcome to prison. Homework was done at the table, use of pencils and paper regulated, and inventory counted. Bedtime was at 6, lights out at 7, and the doors locked until morning. Bathroom must be used before bed or you have to go in the pot put in your room. It is up to you to keep it clean. We had two sets of PJs we went to school in, all gray, and a set for bed. It was up to us to keep them clean. Uniform must be maintained, hair must be maintained, our grades must stay high, no excuses, no exceptions. By the time a week was up, she had broken us. N and A stayed stubborn, but even they broke by the second week. Then, the appeals. You want release? Write us an essay on why you think you're ready to return to society. Then an interview to determine leniency. Myself and my younger sister L managed to be allowed outside beyond the yard. It took several days for the others to follow. By the end of the month, we were ready to do anything my mother asked us to do. Then on the same day as the last time, she and RG came into our rooms and dumped garbage bags upon garbage bags. Every book to every Lego was in there, marked with our names. All our stuff was brought back, and my mother dumped them all out on the floor and said, "When I come back up here, whatever is on the floor goes in the garbage." We cleaned that up fast. We never ignored our chores again. While I can't say my parents ever turned our house into a prison when I was growing up, I do fondly remember being chased around the house with a wooden spoon. This is Rob from Karma Comma Chameleon saying thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, and share the video with your friends, and we'll see you in the next one.